name is Kelly Murray. I'm the Supervisor of Instruction. I'm going to just start with a brief introduction of myself and just a little bit of my background. Right now, I'm new to the district. I just joined in the summer. And my responsibilities, I oversee the math, science, technology, health and PE, and family, consumer, and science curriculum. My business cards are up front, so please feel free if you have any questions or concerns to reach out and contact me. I'm more than happy to help in any way I can. As I mentioned, I just joined the district this summer. I do have previous administrative experience as a director of STEM and also as a curriculum coordinator, K-12. And I taught in both California and in Pennsylvania, primarily biology, life sciences, environmental science, and integrated sciences as well. I have a bachelor's of science in animal science, and a master's degree in secondary education, and a doctorate in educational leadership. Probably the most interesting part of this page is the last bullet. I did work at the Los Angeles Zoo as in the animal care and education department. And I share this because working with students at the zoo is really what inspired me to become an educator. I love seeing kids just engage in science that was well beyond what they learned in the classroom. Skills that were so high and loving it. Having hands-on activities and just really being engaged and having a great time with science. And that's really what inspired me to become an educator and to really grasp on to the idea of STEM. Just an overview of what we're going to talk about today. I'm going to start by giving an overview of STEM in general, just so everyone kind of has a common understanding of where we are with STEM, and then also talk about why it's important to focus in on STEM, and then finally I'm going to wrap up with what we're currently doing as a district, and then where we're going to go in the future. As I mentioned, I'm going to start first by talking about what is STEM. STEM simply is an acronym. It stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. But what's most important about this is that STEM focuses on the integration of that content. It focuses on the instructional approaches, how we're looking at inquiry-based approaches, and how we're bringing that discovery and that love of learning for students in a very integrated approach. What we're looking to do is really transform classrooms from a teacher-centered environment to truly a student-centered environment where students are engaged in rich discussion, rich discovery activities, have opportunities to learn through inquiry and learn through discovery, where students have opportunities to look at how different content areas merge together, how the integration is there, and how you're learning math through science, technology, through math, and so on. A picture's worth a thousand words, so I just have a couple of slides here. But we're looking at here where you have a very traditional environment, to really an environment where it's very rich in discovery learning, hands-on activities, and really asking the question, I wonder why, and getting students to wonder and think about why things happen the way they do, whether or not it's math or science or technology and so on. We're looking at the opportunity where many of us probably learned math in math class, science in science class, technology, and engineering separately in isolation. Perhaps there were some college and careers woven in with that study, but it was very much isolated. We're looking to move to that, to more of an integrated approach, where we're learning math through science, where we're taking the math skills that we already are concrete in and saying, well, what does that look like in science? More importantly, what does that look like with the college and career focus? What type of college and careers can we expose our students to? And how can we get students engaged in real life application of the STEM career? Before I move on, any questions about what STEM is in general? Over the next couple of slides, I'm going to talk a little bit about why it's so important to focus in on STEM and why as a district we're really looking at this. Right now, STEM careers are growing exponentially. We want to be able to provide students with the opportunity to fill some of these careers. Right now, the STEM careers are projected to grow about 17% through 2018, which is compared to the 9.8% growth for the non-STEM careers. In addition to that, we're seeing that there are students who, we don't have enough graduates to fill a lot of those positions that have the skill base and the interest in pursuing STEM-related careers. This is just a brief graph that shows just where some of the projected increases are expected. What you see here on this end is projected about 14% increase for all occupations over the next through 2020. The orange are STEM-related careers, just a few of them, but for example, biomedical engineering is expected to grow 62% by 2020. This is according to the U.S. Department of Education. System software development is expected to grow 32%. So we're really seeing exponential growth in STEM-related fields, and we're looking at ways that we can get students really interested in this earlier. What this graph shows is just a distribution of the different type of credits that students can have. For example, bachelor's degree, 41% of STEM careers will need a bachelor's degree, whereas 23% would need a graduate degree, associate's degree, and so on. In addition to the exponential growth of availability of STEM careers, there's also a very large financial benefit. Right now, STEM workers are commanding about 26% higher wages than non-STEM careers, and again, that's expected to grow through 2020. That's according to the U.S. Department of Commerce. And 65% of those with bachelor's degrees are actually anticipated to earn more than those who are holding master's degree in non-STEM-related fields. So we're definitely seeing an imbalance, so to speak, with STEM-related careers that are really growing over the next several years. This graph just, or this table just shows you some of the hourly average earnings. For example, a student with a high school diploma or less in a STEM-related field makes an average nationwide of about $24.82. Non-STEM careers about $15.55, which gives about a 59% difference between STEM-related career and non-STEM-related career. Looking at the bachelor's degree line, it's about 27% increase for STEM-related careers. So overall, there's really not only an increase in the demand, but also financially, there's definitely a lot of benefits. And what we want to be able to do is offer students the opportunity to really hone in on these skills, but also to develop interest and see maybe they have an interest in a career that they didn't even know existed. Many times we're actually preparing, especially some of our younger students, for careers that don't even exist yet. So we're really taking a look at the curriculum and seeing how we can build in inquiry-based critical thinking skills to help students pursue careers that we don't even know what those are yet. I'm going to talk a little bit about what we are currently doing to prepare students for STEM. This page here is a nice handout that just shows overall the activities that are available to students in the district at all levels. Your first page is elementary, second is middle school, and the final page is high school. What I encourage you to do is review these. If you think that your son or daughter might be interested in pursuing some of these, definitely reach out to the contact person. What we're looking to do, again, is really get kids interested early. Many times students have made up their mind, whether or not they're good or bad at science, and they build that wall. We want to try and get them interested early, build that capacity, and get them really loving, hands-on, real-life, authentic application. So what you'll see here again are different clubs and activities that are mostly after school. For example, elementary, you'll see activities such as the science fair, Lego and robotics, nature environmental club, science explorers, and iPad integration. At the middle school, you'll see activities such as math counts, ED the chemist. One of the new activities we just introduced recently is a program called Tech Girls. Tech Girls is a program designed at incorporating technology integration for girls at the middle school level. I'm really excited about this opportunity because, again, not only are we seeing such a demand in careers, but we're seeing a very large gender discrepancy with STEM-related fields. And we're finding that girls are not going into STEM-related fields as much as boys are. This is a great activity for students, for middle school girls to get involved in some STEM-related activities and really hope to bring some real-life meaning and bring some fun to technology and get some girls hooked. You'll see some of the other activities that we have going on. And again, for a full description, please see this page. And then finally, at the high school, again, several activities. But what I also included were several elective courses that are available for students at the high school that students can also choose to participate in. But really, there's already a nice wide range of activities that students can participate in, but in a moment I'm going to talk a little bit about what we're going to be doing to expand that even further. Any questions so far on what we're currently doing?
Are these programs just for students in the, for example, times in the day, or they're available to private school students after school.
Let me get back to you on that one. If you can stop and ask me afterward. But most of these are after school activities.
Mm-hmm.
But how it impacts private school students, let me get back to you on that. Let's chat about that.
One question, and you may not know the answer to this, but under Radnor, they have like a Lego robotics club, but it says gifted and talented. So does that mean it's not for everyone?
No, if students are interested, it's an after-school PTO-sponsored club, so please reach out to that sponsor and become involved, absolutely.
Okay.
The next part, I want to talk a little bit about what we're doing to take this further and where we see ourselves going. First and foremost, we're in the midst of a STEM review. As I mentioned earlier, one of our priorities is making sure that students are exposed to STEM activities and STEM careers early. So we're in the process of doing a K-12 STEM audit. What that means is that we're looking at our curriculum, looking at what's being taught high school right down to kindergarten, how it's being taught, what instructional strategies we're using, and what opportunities students have to look at hands-on science activities. Hands-on technology integration. We've contracted with the Lancaster Lebanon IU to conduct that review. They're actually in the process now. And in the early summer and fall, they've been reviewing our curriculum documentation. Actually, starting today, there were review teams on site coming into our classrooms and looking at instructional strategies that we're using. The end result toward the end of January is to have a report that will report on our findings. Give us feedback on our strengths, let us know where we can grow, and give us some recommendations for future implementation. What's most important, I think, is this next step in February and May. This is where I'm really reaching out to everyone in the room. Our ultimate goal is to create a shared STEM vision. What that means is really looking at what does it mean to have a solid STEM program in the district. And with that, create a 3 to 5 year plan of how we're going to implement that. I don't want to do this in isolation. I don't want to sit in my office and say, okay, here's where we're going. I want to involve local universities, local organizations, STEM-related professionals, parents, teachers, students, administrators, and really helping us decide how can we make this a great STEM program as a district. The ultimate goal is to emerge as a leader in STEM, and really looking at how our science, technology, engineering, and math curriculum is rigorous, how we're giving students the opportunity to provide chances to engage in real-life application with the career focus, and really being able to do science and do technology within the classroom, not just learn about it. This visual kind of gives an idea of just where we're going. Ultimately, we have the district mission and vision. And under that, we're looking at how we're going to expand our STEM programming. And there's three kind of main areas that are emerging. Number one, we're looking at our curriculum. This is the daily. What does our curriculum look like in the daily classroom? What's being taught? How is it being taught? And how can we best emphasize the STEM fields within our daily curriculum? The second part is our college and career focus. Looking at how we can really integrate a real-life practical application within our curriculum, and seeing how we can potentially partner with community organizations, local STEM organizations, and also university partnerships to help really exemplify what we want from our STEM education. And then finally, looking at our extracurricular and academic competitions, the activities that you have here, can we expand them? Is there room to expand and take it to the next level? Are there additional clubs and activities, different offerings that we can provide for students? So this is kind of where we're going in general. Again, we're in the process of waiting for the STEM review to be completed and to hear the recommendations from that team, but I'll be looking in February or so to convene a team who might be interested in helping us mold this vision and help us take it to the next step. So having said that, I do have one more handout. This is just an opportunity for me to start the ball rolling on getting some feedback from you, feedback on where you think that we need to focus, and if you're interested in potentially participating in one of those focus groups in February, please leave me with your contact information. Again, I'd love to hear your feedback. I'd love to hear your thoughts on where you think we should go and how we can incorporate that.
I just have a question. Is the district involved with any local STEM-based companies that will either include children in internships or come in or infuse money into the school or develop?
That's where we want to be going. I've been having some conversations with some, but I really want to look at how we can really, like you said, bring in the internships and those partnerships. So that's where we're going. We are doing that to some degree, yes, but I think that that's definitely an area we can expand on. And certainly if you are in one of those STEM-related careers as a professional, I would love to pick your brain too.
Are you looking at some of the other schools who have been successful in this?
Yes, definitely. Part of my position is looking at not only local areas, what they're doing, but across the country, what they're doing that works, what some of their pitfalls were, and how we can, you know, borrow ideas of things that have already been working.
There's a school in the Great Valley School District that's a STEM, I think it's sort of classified as a STEM school.
There are some schools that are classified as specifically STEM schools, especially nationwide. They've kind of come out over the last couple of years. So I'm definitely going to do some research into those and seeing again what they're doing and how their programming is developed.
Have you considered what something that I've heard at more of the collegiate level and particularly at Drexel was instead of STEM, STEAM, mm-hmm. with the arts integrated, and in particular for this school district where you have a focus and you have at least a commitment to the arts, and really in your vision of really wanting to be different, the opportunity here would be to integrate all of this plus with the arts side of it.
It's funny you brought that up because the other supervisor of instruction and I, we were just talking about this just before the session, in looking for natural merges where you can incorporate the arts. I think what's important is that you look for ways that it naturally fits, not try and force it.
Right.
But particularly when you're looking at graphic design, graphic
yeah.
arts, that's absolutely looking at the integration of how arts is supporting that.
Right, and fashion and wearables and
absolutely.
All that. So, you know, and Drexel's got a really creative center where they're doing very cutting-edge innovation.
Great. And those are some of the resources I'm hoping to start to pull in and say, you know, how can we incorporate some of these ideas?
Mm-hmm.
One of the things I think is important is that we bring together those ideas and create the shared vision, but that we're very purposeful and intentional. We can't do everything under the sun, but saying, here's where we're going to go this year. That's why we'll have a 3 to 5 year plan that really focuses on that. But absolutely, I need those ideas.
And did you already have a Tech Girls program? Or is that, I mean...
The Tech Girl program is new this year.
Yeah. Yeah, and I'm familiar with the people running that. They are excellent, and they had spoken in the past that they were interested, they were focused more in the city, so they were very interested in making their way out
mm-hmm.
to the main line, so that's great to hear.
I'm really excited about it.
Yeah.
If you have a daughter in middle school or know a girl in middle school who might be interested, please reach out to the contact on the paper because we're really, really trying to provide this amazing opportunity for girls, so... The workshops run on Saturday. I think there is an October workshop. I want to say it is coming up soon. I don't remember the exact date, but they run throughout the winter, and they don't have the new spring schedule up. So even though it's already starting, it's already rolling, students can still join, absolutely.
Are you interviewing students and getting feedback from the students on their perceptions on STEM and where they feel they fit?
I think student feedback is critical, so yeah, we'll definitely be incorporating that. What that's going to look like yet, I don't know, but we will definitely be incorporating that.
Because I think kids do have these preconceptions, and you know, they put themselves in a box, and it, part of the program would be kind of nice to, you know, maybe break down some of those.
Truthfully, I think that's part of the problem, is breaking down some of the preconceptions, and students build that up so early. I know just even some of my friends, thinking back to when I was younger, they already decided they were good or bad at math or whatever it was. And it's really hard to break down those walls. And a lot of times we're preparing students for careers that we don't even know exist yet. So being able to just get students exposed to that
I have a son who struggled with math, and I put him into a program that was outside of the classroom, and it just changed his perception. He loves math. Had I not taken him out of this classroom and exposed him elsewhere,
I don't think that would ever have happened.
And I think that comes down to some of these activities that are here too. Sometimes that students are doing math that's so far above the level of what they may be doing in the classroom, but they love it. They're engaged in it. They're having a great time. I mentioned my experience at the zoo. That's what I loved seeing. I had students working on genetics, you know, middle school kids, and they loved it. They had no clue they were learning science. It was embedded with what they enjoyed, and it connected to an interest. So I think that's what we're hoping to bring.
My question is kind of related to that. All these programs are fabulous, but they're after school. Is there any room for this sort of, these sort of programs within the school day for the kids
we'll
that
be looking
for whatever
at
reason can't participate
right
after school?
We'll be looking at that. I couldn't answer that right now, but we'll certainly be looking at ways that we can weave in, whether or not it's a program or just some of the concepts and ideas into our curriculum and seeing how it embeds within our curriculum. But that's definitely something that we're looking at. I'm sorry.
Where is this information on the website for these workshops or tech goals and stuff? But I've never heard of it.
I want to say yes, but it depends on which level you are at. I can't direct you exactly where it is, but if you have any specific questions about it, feel free to send me an email and I'll track down the information for you. I know the middle school has a clubs page that has all that information on it, but I'm hoping that this will at least be a start as far as getting a contact person for you in each of the schools. The best bet for more information is taking a look at this this column on the right, because it does give you the contact person's name, so try touching base with them. But at any point, if you have questions, feel free to reach out to me too, and I'll track down an answer for you. But one of the things I'm going to be looking at is having a STEM communication page, so it's kind of a central location for resources for people. Well, I thank you very much for your time. If you wouldn't mind just giving me some feedback, and just you can just drop it off on the table on your way out.